I just gave you level 3 security clearance. Now, head to the security room and use the cameras to watch the door to the server farm. Unfortunately, Melanie's in there now. So when I escort her out, that's when you make your move. I'd wipe these servers myself, but as the head of IT, I'd be a suspect. It has to be someone they've already locked up. Ah, these Templars. They run up. What the hell are you doing? This is no time to go back to work. I'm entering the server room now. When you see us leave, get it.
Yourself, Miss LeMay. My team will handle the investigation.
But you need an extra set of eyes on this thing, John. We don't even know when the hackers broke in. It could take weeks to go through this data.
One, at most.
Still too long. I can't keep my team locked up for a week.
Legally, you can. It's what they signed up for, even if they didn't read their contracts.
Yes, of course. I just hate the idea. So what's the next step?
My team is processing the data now. We'll start sifting through it tonight. Scouts on her. Coffee's on me, okay?
All right. I ditched her at the coffee stand. Find a server containing the network logs. Since I have a record of each and every one of your hacks, we'll just search for the timestamps on those and turn that data into something harmless. Easy as that. Here we are. Beautiful. I'll update your communicator one more time. A little program I cooked up just for this purpose. There we go. I think that worked. Try it out.
can feel you, Cypher. Feel. But hardly touch. Signal is still too weak, and I am spread thin. Unfocused. Like static and fog. Lingering in networks and nodes, the nervous system of the world.
Can you hear?
Perhaps the temple was opened too soon, but this was not my choice. The cataclysm pushed all doubt aside. We bless poor Desmond, who gave his life so that you, the children of our labors, would live on. To fulfill your purpose in ours, in mine. But now is not the time. My strength is not sufficient to inhabit an organic vessel. There's more work to do, more samples to acquire, more artifacts to find before my will can attain.
What's happening? Tell me!
Make me whole again, my children, my instruments. Bring me forth to fulfill your purpose.
Tell me! No, no, no! Something's wrong! God damn it! She should be here! Now! Living in that goddamn head of yours! Fuck, 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 fuck! Why did she spare you? Why are you still here?
Charges, sir, I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother, married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastards, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck. Till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in his infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duck the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
What's your name? Billet? Ken Moore? Conway?
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
And that's the rumor going round. As dirty and daft a pirate has ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. And back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
Oi! Jesus.
Quiet, you! Stop your twaddle!
Oi! Quiet! Hey! Quiet!
Open this gibbet!
Hey!
Oi! Open this gibbet!
Stop that!
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Hold a moment.
Interloper, raise the alarm!
Whip! Disappeared. Damn it! Ah!
your scalp!
Yes!
Money like Steve Bonnet from Barbados. Did they? Serves the bastard right.
Much of a friend, Jack Rackham, nor an able sailor, neither. But you were strange and lively, and you made me laugh more than once. And that's enough to make me sorry for seeing you like this. I hope you found a lasting peace down there among the dead.
need some help here.
Hello!
Help me, damn it!
You! Halt! He's off! Bastard's trying to get away! You!
Interloper!
Aye, stop.
It's all there. I need some help here.
Stand still.
Done for now.
Your head. Ooh.
Stop, I want to talk to you.
Hello! Help me, damn it!
Who's in on it?
You're not going anywhere. You won't take us that way.
Stop!
I think not. Get back here now! Hold you!
I've got a shot! I think I can hit him!
Vane. At Court Wind, you'd been discovered and brought here.
Health to the king.
Didn't hear what happened after, though.
Dodge me!
That's the luck you made. I wish we'd parted as friends.
Mary, it's me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh! Oh! Oh!
I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent. Can you walk? Oh! Oh! Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Don't die on my account. Go.
This is such a pain in the ass. Damn it. You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
with you, can we? Oh, well. What happened to Mary? What's wrong?
Is she gone?
Oh no. Oh God! Oh!
What will you do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edwin Kenway.
Bring a bottle.
I see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in 1/5 the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. I give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it.
I'll sweeten you, maggot. I'll cut you down!
little puppy, and slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness. Robert!
Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Raise a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Captain Kenway, you look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I should have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving.
Aye, Edward. For I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.